colocation, and again, I'm kind of two, flavors of colocation, because I've had the opportunity at NASA to have, a very reasonable office, and it's nice having your privacy and so on. But I did see the effectiveness of that cubicle approach and the colocation at SpaceX. There's no doubt about that as far as people being able to work very, very efficiently and effectively with one another. And to tell you the truth, I was actually quite skeptical at first that, well, how can you hear yourself think here? And there's all this commotion. How are you going to get any work done? And it does take, I'll say, a few weeks to kind of get used to it and kind of adapt. And I guess if you're very noise sensitive, that might be more of a problem for you. But I think there's no doubt of how efficient that is when, again, you have a clear project that you're working on. And again, one of the big advantages SpaceX has is that they have a pretty clear line of products they're working on, okay? NASA, we have a very broad array of different projects hardware and other things that we're working. SpaceX, and what they have, their Falcon 9, they have their Dragon. I mean, they have, you can count them on one hand, the different primary products they're working on. So it makes it a little bit easier. Everyone's working on the Falcon 9, okay? So, okay, well, everyone's working on the Falcon 9. Yeah, there's a lot of commonality there. When you have a large array of projects and activities like we do at NASA, accomplishing the same co-location is, I would imagine, challenging, okay? So unless you have very large projects. SLS, I guess, is probably a good example. But now you have people around the country, okay? So co-location is, again, a bit of a challenge there. Now, SpaceX does have several facilities. They have the McGregor Test Facility, but those are clear demarcations between designing and building the rocket in Hawthorne, and then at McGregor, testing the rocket, okay, and then at KSC and eventually at Brownsville, launching the rocket. So those are really major, functional differences. And so NASA doesn't have that luxury because of our history and the distribution of centers around the country, the political interest in keeping centers around the country. There are some natural challenges we have that SpaceX doesn't. But nonetheless, there's no doubt that when you have people working on a project, okay, and that's their primary role, if they're co-located, I think there's no doubt from what I saw at SpaceX that is very efficient for making progress.